my path.
Rejoice in the Lord always, in the word, right? Rejoice in the Lord always, and then again, I say rejoice. Do you know where anywhere in the Bible where he's repeating himself unnecessarily?
No.
He says, rejoice in the Lord always, and then again, I say rejoice. Why do you think that he might have said that? Because there are so many things that are going on in this life, in the world that we live in, that can blindside us or sidetrack us.
Yeah.
Something that quickly just shows up in your lap, unexpected, and it throws you into a mental and an emotional wreck all of a sudden. And you're Christians and you're believers and you love God and you trust God, right? Those of you that are walking with the Lord, have a relationship with Him. We are not to be of this world, the Bible says. And the only way to function in the realm of the kingdom of God is to rejoice in the Lord always. And then when you get blindsided by life, things that don't go your way or things that you didn't expect, he says, rejoice in the Lord always. And then again, I say rejoice, because you're going to get blindsided. This world will show up with all of its issues, all of circumstances, things that you don't expect showing up, and you're going to have to rejoice again, or you're going to get trapped in this world. So the reason why we sing this song is this is the day that the Lord has made. Whether it's raining, or whether the sun is shining, whether there's a tornado or hurricane coming, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And get to the place where Job said, the Lord giveth, Pastor Ian, and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. My life does not function based on what I see, but based on who I know.
Yeah.
He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. God, He is God. He is in control. And I am good with that. And whatever He sees fit to navigate in my path, I will receive from Him. The scripture says, have we not received also the bad, the things of the Lord, evil from the Lord, and also good? We receive good from the Lord. How many have no problem receiving all the good things that God has to offer? But how many know that God also puts obstacles in front of us and says, blessed are they that overcome?
Yes.
Well, listen, you're not going to be any runner worth anything if you don't know how to overcome and run.
Yeah.
And sometimes the training is rough ground. How many of you know that training, life, the training ground of life is difficult at times?
Yeah.
Well, you know what? I have a great trainer. I have a great trainer, and he is so good to us. And that's why we sing that song, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. So the next obstacle that you have in front of you, the next thing that doesn't go your way, the next time you look at maybe a bank statement and it's not what you think it should be, rejoice. Because see, he takes care of those that trust in him. He does. He's a God who takes care of his children. And all you have to do on a father, and that doesn't even have to be a Father's Day like today, but all you got to do is say, Daddy, I need you. All you got to do is say, Daddy, I need you. And so that's where we're kind of at right now. Father, we say, Daddy, today, happy Father's Day to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Father, for being in our life. Thank you, Father, for being here right now. The Bible says that He inhabits the praises of His people. And where two or three are gathered, He's there in the midst of us. And how many are glad that He's here right now with us?
Amen.
In the beautiful shade trees, as the sun is shining and the wind is blowing, can you just feel His presence as we continue to worship? I just want you to continue to kind of just stay in that place where we trust God and know God is everything we need, everything we desire, our hope, our future, our past. He's everything. And so, Lord, we worship You because we recognize without You we are nothing. We exalt You and we praise You because we know as we lift our voice and we become true worshipers that Your kingdom's gates are open. We thank You, Father, for that. And Father, if our eyes are closed to any degree, we ask You to open up our eyes, Lord, that we would see You. Syria, blessing, Lord, prosperity, wisdom, Father, that wisdom would rush in. Bring counsel, Lord, counsel from heaven, and bring every family and home into order. Let the community of the kingdom, Father, that a church would shine its light in this area. Bring counsel, train and equip and raise up men and women of God to be a blessing in this area, Father God. Raise up a standard here, Father. Raise up a standard here, Father. On the pews to minister to Your people, Lord God. The voice of truth go unfettered. That Your word and Your kingdom would come and break sin and the chains of strongholds and bondages, Lord, in this area, Father.
Yes.
That Your word become alive, Your sword go forth, pierce the hearts of men and women.
Yes.
They would come into the knowledge of who You are and the Savior. The blood of a Savior that washes away all sin, Father, all past, all sickness, that Your blood has brought us in to Your kingdom. No matter what we've done, Lord, or where we've been, or issues, or families we've come from, Lord God, Your blood has covered us and cleansed us and made us whole. And brought us in back to where we are reconciled with You. We are so thankful for that, Lord. We're thankful for the gift of Your Savior, Your Son, the perfect sacrifice of a loving God, an unconditional love that loves us genuinely. And I pray for that unconditional love just to seep out and really bless families here, the desire to know You and be loved. I thank You, Father. We give You praise and honor and glory, for You are good.
Yeah.
You know, it's hard for some, for people in the world. Just saw a picture of a table, a long table here through here in the spirit realm. And a lot of people, you know, we all say we've all been to church, we've been somewhere, but a lot of people have actually never been in a church. Even though they live in America, even though there's one maybe on every other corner, a lot of people just don't go. Haven't been, they've heard stuff, they just rather not. Or they think they have to be qualified to enter into a church. Or they have to do some kind of religious ceremony. Or because they don't know something about God, they'd rather not go and make a mistake and look stupid. You know, people have all kinds of things in their head that keep them from being around church buildings. But You make it really simple being out here, because you can hang out on a swing set or sit on the tailgate of a truck or just slip around the corner from down the street. So this is a good work. But for those of you that are within the sound of our voice that have never maybe tasted, this is a fun little song about tasting Him. How many, when you were a child, didn't want to eat your green beans? How many as a child maybe didn't want to eat broccoli? Somebody put cheese on it once and you were sold. Well, it's kind of like that.
Church is operating, you get to walk side by side with people who go through stuff. People pass away, loved ones, people lose jobs at times. There are things that occur in this life that are there for our dealing with. And it's a wonderful thing to be able to walk and see Christ worked out in the lives of the people that you love. You can't beat that. Right, Casey? You can't beat that. When you see the fruit of Him working in lives of people that you love and are close to. You know, this brother right here, he sings pretty, okay? But I tell you, God's put him through the ringer. And some bad theology will say, wow, the devil, we're going to kick the devil out. But there's times when God tries our hearts. And he's creating diamonds. And he's creating fine gems. And he does that with pressure at times. And I've seen this man walk. Not a more beautiful thing than seeing somebody walk through fires, through circumstances. It's not just playing church, it's life. If you ain't got it day by day, you ain't got what you need to get through. And just love on each other and love you, and let everything else go. Let everything else go. And you do sing pretty.
Yeah. Upon this place,
this is a fishing expedition.
He began a good work in you.
Community to know what's so special about this. I'm a Church of God minister, but we're all Christians here. And my brothers here stepped up to the plate when we lost a minister that's gone to Atlanta for 1 week. So the word keeps on going out, being more powerful than the next day and the next day. Because Jesus is going to take over Hopkins Park and it's going to spread. And everyone's going to see the salvation of God here. Amen. And it's not going to be an Episcopal church, a Church of God church. It's going to be a church of God, for God, and by God. Amen. In the name of Jesus, I pray that all of you will have traveling mercies as you go home today. That your first thoughts will be of God and your last thoughts when you go to bed will be of God. You're dismissed. Amen. Amen.